My name is Adam, or Epos Vox, and this is 6 Windows 10 Features That You Should Know About. Number 1. The Start menu has been reimagined again. Microsoft's reimagination of the classic Start menu as a full-screen start screen in Windows 8 did not go over so well with a large portion of consumers. The drastic UI change has caused many, especially the elderly population, to cling to their decade-old Windows XP computers to avoid using. Thankfully, Microsoft has taken the immense amount of user feedback over the last couple years of Windows 8 and redesigned the Start menu for Windows 10 to be a kind of blend between Windows 7 and Windows 8. The left side of the Start screen is basically your classic Windows 7, Windows Vista, Windows XP start menu, which has your folders and your shortcuts to your programs, as well as your user information and power controls. The right side of the Start menu features your universal apps, or what they used to be called, Metro apps. So all of your previously just Windows 8 applications. And you can arrange those as live tiles however you wish. Number 2. The command prompt has finally entered the 21st century. Microsoft announced that you could finally use Control V to paste in the command prompt, which you've not ever been able to do before now. And if you right-click the title bar of the command prompt, you can actually enable some experimental features, such as changing the opacity of the command prompt window like you can in Linux, add extra edit keys, and wrap text with a lot of different text wrapping options. Number 3, Microsoft has improved app switching and added in virtual desktops. Virtual desktops, or workspaces, have been a feature in Linux for a very long time. You could do this in Windows with third-party software, but it's never been supported before. Changes to the visual Alt-Tab dialog were made in Windows 8. However, Microsoft realized that most people just simply click on the taskbar instead of using Alt-Tab, so they moved Alt-Tab to actually switch between virtual desktops. If you don't have virtual desktops, it will of course switch between your applications, but if you create multiple desktops, it will switch between applications in different virtual desktops. Number 4 is Windows Explorer's Home option. Windows 8 added in This PC instead of My Computer, which added libraries on top of removable devices to your My Computer screen. Windows 10 takes it a step further and actually separates This PC and Home. Home consists of your favorites, your frequent folders, and recent files. This PC still functions relatively the same. Number 5. You now have better Snap Assist in Windows 10. In Windows 8, you had a lot of different Snap options as well as Windows 7, and in Windows 10, it's even better. Windows 8 users will remember when you were able to resize basically your desktop space and then click in the empty space and add in a new application. This kind of works the same, but now on the desktop. So if you resize a window to the right side of the screen, on that second half, it's gonna pop up a little mini app switcher option, which is gonna show apps you have open and allow you to choose which one you open in that other space and resize it accordingly. You also have a variety of other snap options to snap windows in various places for higher productivity. Lastly, Microsoft has virtually removed the barrier between the Metro or Modern, or now they're calling it Universal, apps and user interface and the desktop. Windows 8 called Metro apps, now called Universal apps, such as the Windows Store and Windows Store exclusive apps, are now able to be ran on the desktop and resized and maximized and played with on the desktop. To get to their options for those windows, there is an icon on the title bar of those windows, which opens up a list of settings and options similar to the previous Charms menu in Windows 8. Windows 10 is due out in 2015, and there's probably a lot more changes coming that we don't know about yet. This has been 6 Windows 10 features that you need to know about. My name has been Adam Maripos Fox, and I hope you enjoyed. Thank you for watching. See you in the next video.
Thanks for watching Epos and Chew. Let's play together. If you enjoyed the video, consider clicking on the screen to contribute to our Patreon campaign. To watch another video, click on one of the video annotations on the screen above. Links are also provided to our website, Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter pages. See you next time.